Hey everyone, I'm Jeff Hollan, product manager here at Snowflake. I'm really excited to show you in action some of the exciting features that we've recently announced. Here, I want to demo for you using the new Git integration with Snowflake. I'm going to use this with Snowpark. And I also want to show you a new private preview we have for doing local testing of my Snowpark data frames entirely on my machine. So for this example here, you'll notice I'm using VS Code. This is my preferred editor of choice. And to keep it simple, I've written a very, very simple procedure here. I'm just going to get a table and return it back. Now, I could always run this locally ever since Snowpark has been released. But in order for this to actually work, I need what's called a session. And before now, that session has always been a live connection to my Snowflake account. Now, on the one hand, for many scenarios, this is super valuable because that session can give me secure access to actually test and debug with my data. But sometimes I might want to be able to iterate more quickly without having to have a live connection to Snowflake. So one of the things we've announced now in private preview is this ability to do local testing in Snowpark. You can see in my code here, what this looks like is I can now create a connection, but say use a mock server connection. Don't worry about a username and password and connecting to my Snowflake account. Do all the processing here on my machine through Python and VS Code. So to test this out, I can run this just like I would any other Python program. So we'll go ahead and just say Python app.py to run the code. And you'll notice here, it's returned back a Snowpark data frame. This was all built locally without any connection to Snowflake. So this is awesome. I can now build tests on this, do breakpoints, whatever I need to. Now, when I want to take this and run it in production or collaborate with my team members, I can integrate with Git to use this secure backplane for CI/CD and DevOps. So I've gone ahead already, and I have this repo in GitHub that has the code we were just looking at. So here's that logic that we were just seeing here in GitHub. And with the new integration with Git and Snowflake, I can now create a secure connection between my Git repo and my Snowflake account. So you can see here that I've given it credentials to connect to my GitHub account. I've allowed an integration with GitHub or GitLab or Azure DevOps or Bitbucket. And here now I'm saying, hey, have access to all of the data in this Git repo, that one I was just showing you, hello, Snowpark Git. What's cool is I can actually now view all the files in this repo natively within Snowflake. So I want to see all the files that are in the main branch right now. So I can go ahead and just run this command, and you can see here's all the files that I'm looking at over here on GitHub, over here, now accessible within Snowflake natively. So this means I can also now create a procedure, but you're noticing I'm actually going to use the copy of app.py from my main branch. So if I go ahead and now call this now, it's going to return back the same logic I did locally. The big difference is here in this run, I'm actually connecting to Snowflake and my actual data. So you'll see that the data is a little bit different. Okay, so there's the results, and you can see here's ID and name. But now, because I have this all wired up, I can quickly make changes and collaborate with my team member and update this function. So let's come back here to Visual Studio Code and just add a very simple change. I want to filter this to columns where ID equals 1, just to test this out. Now I'll open up Git, and I'll add this as a new Git commit. Let's say add a filter, and I'll push this back to that repo that I looked at earlier. So now my changes from my local session have been pushed, and if I even refresh this file in GitHub, you'll see here, now my file in GitHub is refreshed. So if I want to, I can check out this repo again. We'll check that this is also fetching the changes and refreshing. So now, without me having to recreate my procedure, I'm just going to go ahead and run it again. This is the same procedure we ran a few seconds ago. And here now is that new logic. You can see it's only returned one row in this case because filter ID equaled 1. So now my entire team can collaborate, edit with the combination of local testing and new Git integration. This works fantastic for Snowpark, Streamlit, native apps, or even just SQL scripts that I want to use for source control or versioning. Thanks everyone for watching, and enjoy the rest of your day.